really good way of showing you how inflation has affected us all since 1966 is to go back to that year when we had perhaps a pound for our pocket money if we were lucky, and it would have bought all this lot, a real load of goodies, including lemonade, some bird seed for the budgie, some lollipops, some chocolate bars, some chewing gum, some fruit sweets, 3 packets of crisps, 3 model toys, some chocolate drops for the dog, and even a couple of comics. Well, that was back in the happy halcyon days of 1966, 10 years ago. But let's move on. Let's move on 5 years to 1971. If you got a pound for your pocket money in those days, it would have bought you this. Not quite so much. Still your 2 cans of lemonade, some birdseed for the budgies, but not so many toys, not so much chocolate or crisps, but still your 2 comics. Well, 5 years on, in 1976, when a lot of you will be getting £1 of pocket money, let's see what that'll buy. Not very much, is it? Just 1 can of lemonade, not really very much for the old budgie, 1 toy, a few bits of chocolate and sweets, 1 packet of crisps, and just 1 comic. Quite a change from 1966. So that's how inflation has affected your pocket money. But what about Christmas time spending?
Well, what about it? If we'd taken £5 out today to buy some early Christmas presents for 1976, we would have bought the following things, which we've got in the box here. A book, and a single record, and a flower press. All very nice things. A box of chocs, and some perfume. And that lot would have cost us almost £5 today. In fact, it would have given us just 8 pence in change. Now, if you'd gone out in 1971 and bought exactly the same things, you would have brought back £2.21 in change. If we go further back to 1966, those wonderful days, and bought exactly the same things, you would have come back with £3.28 in change. That is inflation.